pretty rugged mountains up here. Well, this is supposed to be a road. What are you looking at, Cal? He's gonna wait for me to fall out. That's what he's gonna do. That road went right through the river. But we're still heading towards El Frente. And, we're kind of beginning to wonder whether we're going to get there in the daylight. More chickens. More water.
Yeehaw!
That's what I'm talking about. Really wild here. You got painted rocks. Along the side of the road, on the left side, on the right side, they painted white dots on them. And I think that's so you can drive through here safely at night, probably. Uh-oh. There's a big peril on my butt. And then they got some attack roosters down here. And there's a jackass. He's got attack roosters. Yeah, look at this, how they painted us through here. Hey, the old man can still pull a wheelie. Ho! We're off in a creek now. Oh, I just realized I went the wrong way. Well, they say not to ride in Mexico in the dark. So, I'll just turn on my own sunlight, my God. Better turn that off, I'll blind my buddy. Okay, we're coming into El Frente, which is a pretty good sizable town. Looks like the locals are getting ready to celebrate a little bit. Look, got these fires going in the middle of the road. Man, is that cool. I don't know what that's all about. I better pass him so he knows where he's... I know one's got to navigate his GPS is still broke. We got to fix it tonight.
Okay, it's Saturday, February 16th. Me and Tim have rode our bikes. We started at Presidio, Texas, rode through Onondaga. We stayed the first night in Milnawaba, second night in Bumoragami, and now we're in El Frente, which is a kind of a fair-sized city for the adventure crowd here. And we rode in the dark to get here. Man, we just had a really tough day. Dust was bad, but it was good. It was really good riding. So we got us a room here at the solid hotel, and this hotel is the most astounding thing I've ever seen in my life. So we'll shoot that here in a minute. Man, our toilet has a seat. You don't always get a seat in Mexico, but it's got a seat. And normally the hot's on the left and the cold's on the right. In this shower, the hot's on the bottom and the cold's on the top. So let's just take a walk down the street. We have the town square. Like some kind of a tropical trees over there. We'll try to get a shot of this in the morning.
Okay, here we go.
Need a goose ball. Here's the inner courtyard and some of the rooms here. And that right there is a statue of Zorro. So let's head upstairs to the restaurante. That's a high roller room there. This is, by the way, if you can't tell in the camera, that there's no roof above this. It's open air out here.
Si. Let's get a table.
Too late to eat? I think I want the grande yeah. Chair over here.
Okay. What's that? Is that stuff?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, this is the grande chair.
Yep. There's old Tam, we're waiting on her meal. What did you order? Black bass?
Black bass.
Black bass.
House specialty. That lobster.
I never even heard of it. Anyway, look. Hey, here's the El Frente plaza in the daylight. Look at these beautiful trees. Look at that one tree there. It's straight up and then leaps out right top. That sucker is, 60 feet tall. So we're starting to hear a little music here. Sun's going down in El Frente. We went inside that church earlier, took a bunch of pictures. And anyway, I gotta call my wife. I got mixed up on the time zone. I think she's waiting on me. Everybody's just sitting around shooting the bull and having a good time. We may come out here later tonight. There's a gazebo, inner gazebo. Okay, we're leaving the nice city of El Frente. We're going to be heading north. There's some military guys with the machine guns. Be nice to the machine guns. We better stop this Pemex here and get some gasolina. In the little village of El Nacimiento. Hey, Tim.
Good morning, Mark.
Good morning.
A beautiful morning for a ride.
El Nacimiento. Beautiful little hacienda there. We're getting real close to the ferry. I don't know, about 4 miles from the ferry. It's kind of green in here. Got a lot of green vegetation. There's a couple perros gonna eat me alive. Look at the kids. Oh yeah, perro. They're all waving. Get him, Perro. Get him, Perro. Look at that old Volkswagen. I've kind of always thought they were making them old Volkswagens out here in Mexico, but that's the first one I've seen. Tim Mateo! We found out Tim's name in Spanish is Tim Mateo. We found out my name is Marcos, alias El Perro Grande. Not Perro Grande, El Perro Grande. But we think we're at the ferry. Sometimes I do some thinking and I've thought wrong. But it kind of looks like the end of the road anyway.
Okay, we have just arrived at Lake Huitez. And it's the end of the road. Supposedly, there's a ferry that comes in here and docks and it's going to carry us to the other side. I had to ask Mark if he was absolutely sure we were in the right spot, and he said yeah, and then he told me the ferry only runs from Tuesday till Sunday. Of course today is Monday, so we'll see what happens. We've been sitting here for a little bit. Here's where we came from and rode through a real beautiful little village, and our fearless leader and scout is on top of the rock looking for the ferry, and he's doing what he does, figuring out where to go. So I guess we're just gonna sit here until the ferry shows up or we get tired of sitting here. Okay, well, the ferry's still not here, so we're gonna go up here on top of this hill and take a look and see what we can see. It's very beautiful.
It's been about a 2-hour and 15-minute ride from our motel in Aeropuerto. We were staying at the Posada Hidalgo Motel. We stayed there for 2 days because we was kind of famished. Hey, Tim Mateo, don't fall off that rock. You'll have a headache.
If I do, there will be claw marks going all the way down the side of this rock.
I don't have enough ibuprofen to get rid of your claw mark. Hey, we've been sitting here watching this guy, and I got to zoom in on him before he gets out of view. There's a guy out there all by himself in a boat. Where the hell are you? There he is. We've been watching him paddle. He's probably 4/10 of a mile from me. This thing zooms in really good.
Boss, the ferry. Here comes the ferry. We're not gonna have to swim across.
I'll be darned, here he comes. We're gonna have to get our bikes out of the way here pretty quick so he can get unloaded. But here he comes. Alright, it looks like it is goodbye Sinaloa, or however you pronounce that state. And hello Chihuahua. Hope he knows how to drive this thing. Got a little diesel motor up here. Well, I have dreamed of running this route for, I don't know, 5 or 6 years or when I first heard of it. And it was one of them things that, wow, what a neat thing to do and a nice route to follow. But it's just one of them things that I never thought I would ever be able to do. There's been a lot of places I've been so lucky to go to in the last few years that I never thought I'd get to go to. This is my fourth trip to Mexico, Tim's first, and some other things I've gotten to do. Last two years I went to up in the Pacific Northwest of the United States, and I never thought I would ever get up there ever in my lifetime. I never thought I'd have enough time off work, which I don't work much now, or have enough money. And so me and the gas pipe got up Pacific Northwest twice in the last 2 years, and on a totally different, once on the Trans Am Trail, going all the way to Oregon coast, and another time we rode our 950s all up through 7 or 8 states up through there. So this is, I'm getting almost kind of emotional being here. I really am. What a wonderful view. Okay, I'll turn this off before I start crying. He ain't worried about crying. He's over here feeding his face. We stole these biscuits from the restaurant this morning. I think it's the town of La Reforma down there, or close to it. And we're climbing straight up a mountain here. Right out of that valley and river we were down in. And it's really steep here. Gonna be some spectacular riding, looks like to me. I don't know if there's any villages in between here and the Siena Guita or not. Might be some small ones. The old Husky has got all she wants in second gear here. Well, we went up one mountain and now we're going down one. Imagine that's going to be the order of the day. I don't think Tim will get lost up in front of me without his GPS, because there ain't no place else to go. Man, we have been climbing up this mountain for what seemed like an hour, and we're just about at 8,000 feet. Uh-oh. Kinda spectacular. This road really ain't that difficult, but it's, man, it's been really steep. The switchback's relentless. When I say that, I mean that in a good way. Okay, we're heading down into Eureka, and the Tahermar Indians live in this, live right here. That's their house. I don't know how deep that cave is. I wouldn't never look in it, of course. But Tim's went on ahead of me. And the town of Eureka is down there at the river down there somewhere. Probably can't see it on this camera. That's where we're going. And it's a 5-mile ride from this point down to the river. But in a straight line, it's, you know, it may be only a mile or something, I don't know. But brakes don't fail me now. Old Tim and Tail up there kicking up a big dust cloud. Now I've dropped down to 5,500 feet. I suppose you could coast all the way to the bottom if you wanted to. Looks like we're going to have put in about 125 miles today. Been riding pretty hard all day. Down, down, down. Jackass. This town of Eureka down here, if it's still standing since I was here last time, they had a big building where they had a diesel generator that provided electricity to this town. Of course, that thing was abandoned quite a few years ago when they finally got on the electrical grid. Welcome to Eureka, Chihuahua. We are in Eureka, Chihuahua. We made it.
Back here.
Yeah, that P-Mix was not there before. Yeah, got regular gasoline out of the pump here. Eureka. Battery. Are you amigo? He's an amigo. Yeah, I got camera. Yeah, camera. Oh, no thank you.
No gracias.
No gracias, see. Well, we made it all the way to the town of Timorese from Eureka. And we've ridden down to where the Copper Canyon train comes to a depot down here south of Timorese. They're just one way from Timorese. They're just a dead-end road that comes down here to the train. And this train goes in the mountain and makes a U-turn inside the mountain while dropping couple 300 feet of elevation in the process. There's a depot down there. This train is just something else. I know you can ride it from all the way to the city of Chihuahua to the Sea of Cortez. I know you can do that, but maybe you can get on it somewhere else. I don't know. Look at that waterfall up there. Now right up above that waterfall is another part of the train you're seeing down lower, and it goes in the mountain. And we have not got that totally figured out how that works. Train station, and going to go back to the town of Timorese, and from there we're going to ride to the little town of Tinipaz on the Tinipaz River and hopefully find a place to stay there. Gotta be careful, they got a bunch of pet rolls, a bunch of dogs here, and attack chickens.